Last night, our state took another beating from Mother Nature, and as you know, when storms roll through, contractors from all over are not far behind. Scott Hines goes in your corner.
It just sounded like a massive thunderstorm with people throwing baseballs at the house.
Golf ball-sized hail crashing through people's skylights.
Get back away from the window, sweetheart, because it could break the window.
The storm passed.
It's really pounding the car.
And the knocks started.
Well, a million roof salesmen were coming to my door or calling.
Holly Baum says she couldn't shake the roofers coming after her business.
I just tell them I have a roofer and I'm not interested.
Uh-huh.
Please don't call again.
Okay. Click.
Stephen Hart admits he's one of them.
We like to go hustle. We like to generate our work.
Staking a claim with yard signs.
Are most people friendly when you show up?
You know, most people are, and understandably, the ones that aren't have had literally in this storm probably 40 different people come and banging on their doors, yeah. And most of them probably aren't as easygoing as me.
The In Your Corner bottom line, go with a local established roofer like Steven, who's insured, bonded, and registered with the state. So by law, roofers must give you their roofer ID number. Plus, they're required to put that same number on the side of their pickup, the contract, and if they put a sign in your yard, it's got to be there, too. The state insurance department's anti-fraud unit is also keeping an eye on things.
Go through your insurance policy. Understand it.
The unit's assistant chief, Robert Lee, says take your time when deciding what roofer to go with. And inventory your belongings by uploading photos, video, and information to online places like Dropbox or Google Drive. Or just do it old school.
So you need to have a copy that's retrievable from an off-site location. It can be a friend's house, it can be a safe deposit box, it can be a safe place at work, but someplace other than at your home.
I'm Scott Hines, In Your Corner.
And good advice there. Thank you, Scott. Most contractors are reputable, but it's important to do your homework before entering into a business agreement with a contractor.